Hi students, welcome to Easy Chemistry by Pathan. And today in this session I am going to explain previous year NEET important questions from chemical bonding. As you know very well, chemical bonding is very important chapter for any competitive exam, NEET, CET, JEE, whatever it may be. And here from chemical bonding there is a chance to get 3 to 4 questions, so that is the weightage of this chapter. What type of questions and from which concept they are regularly asking from this chapter, let we discuss. Bond order, every year must and should, hybridization, bond length, bond angle, dipole moment, isostructural and isoelectronic, diaparamagnetic nature, lone pairs and bond pairs, means number of lone pairs and number of bond pairs, ionic and covalent character, sigma and pi bonds. So these are the areas where questions are asking from chemical bonding. Bond order, hybridization, bond length, bond angle, dipole moment, isostructural, isoelectronic, diaparamagnetic nature, number of lone pairs and bond pairs, ionic and covalent character, sigma and pi bond. So compulsory and another important is hydrogen bonding. So these are the areas you have to concentrate from this chapter. As my knowledge, remaining topics no need. You concentrate on these topics. Clear? And today I am explaining 4 concepts, that is bond order, hybridization, diaparamagnetic nature, number of lone pairs and bond pairs. In this video I am explaining 4 main concepts. In from next video I am going to explain few more. Let me start few concepts which are regularly asking for NEET. See here, and questions I pick up from last few years by looking into previous year questions. From bond order, the correct bond order of the following is, so here given based on oxygen ions, so we have to correct a bond order, increasing or decreasing order we have to calculate. So see here, you know very well bond order trick. 14 electrons are there. Question number 1 I am giving 14 electrons, bond order is 3. Remember, 14 electrons are there in given molecule, bond order is 3. Now you go for increasing and decreasing order. Here 13 electrons, 12 electrons, 11 electrons, 10 electrons. So this is a decreasing. Here you increasing, you write 15 electrons, 16 electrons, 17, 18, like this. Am I right? And for 13 electrons, you go for from 3, subtract 0.5. So 2.5. From this, you subtract 0.5. And you are getting 2.0. From this, you subtract 0.5. You are getting 1.5. From this, you subtract 0.5, you are getting 1.0. Same here also, for 15, 2.5, for 16, 2, for 17, 1.5, for 18, 1. So like this you remember. 14 electrons are there, bond order is 3. And after that, increasing or decreasing number of electrons, you subtract 0.5 from each. 3, 2.5, 2, 1.5, 1.5, 0. Like this here also. 3, 2.5, 2, 1.5, 1, 0.5, 0. Like that. Let me calculate number of electrons in this. O2 plus means in oxygen atomic number 8, 2 oxygen 16. Plus means minus 1. Means how many electrons are there? 15 electrons. Next, O2 minus 16 minus means plus 1, that equal to 17 electrons. Next, O2 2 plus. O2 means 16, 2 plus means minus 2, that equal to we have 14 electrons. See here, 14 electrons, 17 electrons, 15 electrons. See, 15 electrons means bond order is 2.5, already we calculated here. 17 electrons means 1.5. Next, 14 electrons means 3. 14 electrons means 3. See here, bond order 3, that is O2 2 plus is more bond order. Next, O2 plus more bond order. Next, O2 minus. So this is first, this is second, this is third. This is third we have. Means bond order is more for O2 2 plus. More for O2 2 plus. See here, option B you take. Option B, O2 2 plus, O2 plus, O2 minus. O2 minus having very least na here. So this is the method to calculate bond order. Clear? So now first question is option B is correct. Next, go for here. Which of the following pairs have same bond order? See here, second question. Question number 2. Same bond order we need. Same bond order. So O2 you know very well. O2 bond order. Here 16 electrons are there. 16 electrons means bond order is 2. Next, NO plus nitrogen 7, oxygen 8, 15 plus means minus 1 means 14. NO plus is 14 electrons. 14 electrons means bond order 3. 14 electrons means bond order is 3. This is option A. Option B you go. Option B, cyanide. Carbon 6, nitrogen 7. Minus 1, 14 electrons. So Cn minus is 14 electrons. 14 electrons, bond order is 3. CO, carbon 6, oxygen 8. Means 14 electrons. 14 electrons means bond order is 3. Bond order is 3. So cyanide, carbon monoxide having bond order same. Clear? So if you know this method, 14 electrons 3, 13 or 15, 0.5 you have to subtract, then you are getting the answer. This you remember, then easy to you to calculate any bond order. So how to calculate bond order trick I am giving link in the description box. You go and watch that video also, then easy to you. So 2 questions we completed. And another question is there here. The correct increasing bond order. You practice. So this is for your practice purpose I am giving. You practice it. This is about bond order. Every year there is a question. You go and search previous year paper. Without bond order there is no question. Is it clear? So bond order easy. Next, another important concept I took, that is hybridization. Here is the question. The hybridization of nitrogen in NO2 plus, NO3 minus and NH4 plus respectively. Bond order we have to calculate. See, to calculate bond order we have certain rules. So that is, we have to calculate valence electrons. If valence electrons are 8 or less than 8, divide with 2. If valence electrons are more than 8, divide with 8. Total valence electrons 8 or less than 8, divide with 2. Valence electrons more than 8, divide with 8. Then you are getting hybridization. See here, the question I am taking NO2 plus. NO2 plus valence electrons. Nitrogen valence electrons, you know, nitrogen in 5th group element, 5 electrons. Plus oxygen 6 electrons, 6th group. So 12. And here plus means minus 1, that equal to 17 minus 1, 16 electrons. What we have to get hybridization? More than 8, divide with 8. So 16 electrons are more than 8. So 16 by 8 equal to 2. So what is 2 here means 2 hybrid orbital. 2 hybrid orbital. 1 s orbital, 1 p orbital. So hybridization is sp. Hybridization is sp. Next, NO3 minus. NO3 minus. Nitrogen 5, oxygen 6, 6 into 3, 18. Minus means plus 1 we have to add. So 24. 24 valence electrons. 24 is more than 8. Divide with 8. 8 threes are 24. 8 threes are 24. 3 hybrid orbital. 3 hybrid orbitals means 3 hybrid orbitals means 1 s orbital, 2 p orbitals. So sp2. Another they given NH4 plus. Nitrogen 5, hydrogen 4, plus means minus 1. That equal to 9 minus 1, 8. 8 valence electrons, 8, here rule I given, 8 or less than 8, divide with 2. So divide with 2, you are getting 4. 4 hybrid orbital, nothing but 1 s orbital, 3 p orbital, sp3. So NO2 plus is sp, NO3 plus is, NO3 minus is sp2, NH4 plus is sp3. Let me cross check. Sp, sp2, sp3. Look here, sp, sp3, sp2, this is wrong. Sp2, sp3, sp, this is wrong. Sp, sp2, sp3. So this is the correct answer. See how much easy. So valence electrons calculate, we have to calculate. Total valence electrons 8 or less than 8, divide with 2. More than 8, divide with 8. This concept video also I given link in the description box. Go and watch the video, then you are getting clarity. Is it clear now? Next, the correct geometry and hybridization for XeF4, xenon tetrafluoride. So hybridization you have to calculate first. Xenon hexafluoride, tetrafluoride. Xenon 8 valence electrons, fluorine 7th group, 7 valence electrons, 7 into 4, 28, that equal to 28 plus 8, 36 valence electrons, more than 8, so 8 you are getting, that equal to 8 fours are 32, plus remainder how much is there, 4 is there, 4 is less than 2, again divide with 2, you are getting 2, that equal to 6, so 6 means 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals, sp3 4, you got, and 2 d orbitals. You know very well this. So sp3d2. So hybridization is sp3d2. Clear? Now structure I am drawing for this. Xenon, you know very well, with 4 fluorine atoms like this, and here one lone pair, and here one lone pair. So this is the structure. So sp3d2. See here, 4 bond pairs, 1, 2, 3, 4, plus 2 lone pairs. So 6. Clear? 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair. 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair means octahedral. Chemical bonding we learned. So hybridization is sp3d2. Structure, that is geometry, is octahedral. 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair is octahedral. Let me go further. Octahedral sp3d2. For first option only correct. And not octahedral, and we have to go for 4 bond pairs, 2 lone pairs. Generally we are calling this is square planar, not octahedral, sorry, square planar. So 4 bond pairs, 2 lone pairs are there, square planar, sp3d2. sp3d2. So this is we are getting here question number 5, I am extremely sorry. And octahedral only. Why? Because 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair, sp3d2. sp3d2. So octahedral and sp3d2. And here one more question. In which of the following central atom does not have sp3 hybridization? So I given already, and you practice this question. Remember, 4 bond pair, 2 lone pairs are there, and that is octahedral only, and you go for octahedral structure. Clear? And that we completed how to calculate hybridization. Clear? Next, another concept I am giving. Here see, in NO3 minus, number of bond pairs and lone pairs are. So we have to calculate number of bond pairs and lone pairs. See, NO3 minus structure we have to draw. Nitrogen, it can make 3 with 3 oxygen. Oxygen can make double bond. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Nitrogen maximum 4 bonds only. Still one lone pair is there. That lone pair can give to oxygen and making dative bond. Dative bond. One is minus. Clear? And this is the structure of NO3 minus. See here how many bonds are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 bond pairs. All electrons participated in bonding. That's why 0 lone pair. 4 bond pair, 0 lone pair. So option D is correct. Option D is correct. 4 bond pair, 0 lone pair. See, to calculate lone pair, we have one trick. Number of hybrid orbitals minus number of surrounded atom. Number of hybrid orbital, we calculated already NO3 minus sp2, means 3 hybrid orbital, minus surrounding atom. How many? 1, 2, 3. So that equal to 0. So 0 lone pair. So how to calculate lone pair? I given link in the description box. Go and watch that video, then easy to you. Next. Which of the following species contains 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair around the central atom? Easy. Go for here. H2O. You know very well H2O. We have 2 lone pair and 2 bond pair. This is bonds, this is 2 lone pair. So they asked 3 bond pair, 1 lone pair. BF3. You know very well boron. planar molecule, boron tor group element, three valence electrons are there, three bond pair, zero lone pair. So they asked one lone pair, so this is also not NO2 minus, so you go for NH2 minus, and this is now NH2 and minus. Here two bond pairs are there, so two bond pairs and two lone pairs are there, so this is also not PCl3. One phosphorus can make bond with three chlorines and one lone pair is there. Five electrons, phosphorus 15th group element, five electrons are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now one lone pair is there, three bond pairs are there. So this is the answer. PCl3 having three bond pairs and one lone pair. And here another, bromine tetrafluoride, the lone pair occupied equatorial position to minimize. So this you have to practice direct from the NCERT test book. Bond pair, lone pair, lone pair, bond pair, repulsion, and it will give some clarity for you. This is about how to calculate lone pairs and bond pairs. Next, another concept I am showing, regularly asking this also, and here you go for which of the following is paramagnetic. So this question also very important, regular question only. Remember how to calculate para and diamagnetic nature. See, if total valence electrons are, total electrons are even number, total electrons are even number, dia, and electrons are odd number, that is para. But some exception, odd number and 10 electrons, 16 electrons, 32 electrons, 32 electrons also para only. Even number dia, odd number para. But though 10, 16, 32 are even number, this is also para. So let me calculate. Nitrogen, atomic number 7. 7 here, 7 into 2, 14 electrons. 14 is even number, so this is a dia. Hydrogen 1, that is we have 2 electrons, is even number, dia. Lithium 3 plus 3 6, 6 is even number, this is a dia, this is a dia, this is also a dia. Oxygen 8 atomic number, 8 into 2 16 electrons, 16 electrons also even number only, but exception case, though it has 16 electrons, it is para. So answer is O2 is para in magnetic nature. So this video also I given the link in the description, how to remember dia para, go and watch. Which species does not exhibit paramagnetic in nature? See here, N2 plus, 14 means 13 electrons. 13 electrons, odd number is para, so this is para. O2 minus, 16 plus 1, 17 electrons means para only, this is also para. CO, carbon 6, oxygen 8, 14 electrons is even number is dia. Am I right? Even number is dia. They are asking, does not exhibit para. So this is a dia. Here you go for 7. Plus here we have one more. 15. This is para. So this is diamagnetic in nature. And here, which of the following correct description? Dia, para, they are given. And you go and practice this. Here also one question I given, Cn minus, NO plus, CO, O2 minus, dia or para, you practice it. So I explain today, one is diamagnetic, paramagnetic, and one is bond pair, lone pair concept, and one is hybridization concept, and one is bond order concept. Four concepts I given clearly. You go and practice these questions and it will be benefitable. And next coming video, I am explaining few more from chemical bonding, that is which I given, like bond length, bond angle, dipole moment, isostructural and isoelectronic, here ionic and covalent character, sigma pi bond and hydrogen bonding. So still, if you have any difficulty, please make a comment. I will clarify your doubts. Surely, be safe at home. Thank you.